Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi students, how are you? Good morning. Okay, today we are going to continue our lesson and this is for meeting 11. And what we are going to talk about, let's see the screen. Okay, let's talk about our topic today. It is about add or subtract, ditambah atau dikurang. And it is related to sum and differences problem, word problems. Ini ada hubungannya dengan penjumlahan dan pengurangan, tapi sudah dalam bentuk soal cerita. Okay, first, let's look at some addition keyword that we usually find in the word problems. First, add, and then sum, and plus, in all, total, both, altogether, increased by, and combined. And then for the subtraction keywords is have left, rest, how many more, difference, take away, minus, and remain. And now let's go to the first example, and I want to show about the how to solve the problem. Okay, this is the first example. On Sunday, Ayla ate 12 sweets. Later that day, she ate 7 more sweets. How many did she eat altogether? Pada hari Minggu, Ayla makan 12 permen. Hari berikutnya, ia memakan 7 permen lagi. Ada berapakah permen yang sudah Ayla makan? Okay. And I want to show you steps to solve the word problem. First, read the problem. Pertama yang harus kalian lakukan adalah membaca soalnya atau membaca ceritanya. And then, reread the problem at least twice. Jadi silakan. Kalau sudah dibaca sekali, baca sekali lagi. Paling tidak, kalian sudah berhasil membaca 2 kali soal itu, agar kalian memahami. And then next, underline the question. Silakan kalian berikan garis bawah pada apa yang ditanyakan atau pertanyaan dari soal itu. And in this case, we usually find the question is in the end of the story. Biasanya pertanyaannya ada di bagian akhir dari cerita itu. And we find this one. How many did she eat all together? Ada berapakah permen yang sudah ia makan? Next, box the keywords. Silakan dilingkari atau ditandai kata kuncinya atau kata yang menunjukkan bahwa itu soalnya harus dijumlahkan atau dikurangi. Can you find it? Okay, in here we find 7 more. Di hari berikutnya dia sudah makan 7 lagi. It means that this problem is talk about addition form. Jadi karena ada kata kunci ini, maka kita sudah tahu bahwa ini adalah soal penjumlahan. Okay, and then after that, let's try to solve this problem. Kalau sudah paham dengan soalnya, sudah tahu apa yang harus dikerjakan, kemudian kita lanjutkan untuk mengerjakan. Okay, first, let's find the numbers in the story. We find 12 and 7, right? Ada 12 dan 7. Karena kita sudah tahu bahwa ini soal penjumlahan, maka kita tuliskan dalam bentuk kalimat matematikanya like this. 12 plus 7. And now, please look at how to solve this problem. First, I want to show you the first way. Sebenarnya ada banyak cara untuk menyelesaikan soal cerita itu. Tapi yang pertama, misalnya akan menunjukkan dengan cara garis bilangan, number line. Okay, let's see the number line. Please look at the number line there. I have number line 250. Ada garis bilangan sampai 50. Okay? And then, please put the first mark in the first number. Silakan tandai untuk menunjukkan bilangan yang pertama. In this case, you will find 12, right? Okay, find the 12 here. And then after that, plus 7. Please, you count on or go to the right for 7 steps. Artinya, silakan kalian menambahkan atau menuju ke arah kanan sebanyak 7 langkah. Okay, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so we get 19. And then we have gotten the number, the result is 19. Okay? And then I will show you the second way. And I will use 100 square. Sekarang misalnya mau menggunakan 100 square to find the result of 12 plus 7. First, find out 12 in the box. Okay, now I will help you to find it. Yeah, this is 12. And then, please go to the right for the 7 steps too. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And now, we are in 19, right? Okay, jadi hasilnya sama, 19. Okay, it means that Ayla has eaten 19 sweets. Jadi, Ayla sudah memakan 19 permen. And let's see the other ways to solve the problem. Okay, now let's read the second problem. Kia baked 43 cookies for the school bake sale. Mika baked 22 cookies. And how many cookies did they make altogether? Kia sudah memanggang 43 cookies untuk dijual di sekolah bersama-sama dengan temannya. Kemudian Mika memanggang 22 cookies. Pertanyaannya, ada berapakah cookies yang sudah mereka buat bersama? Okay? First, after you read the problem, let's try to use another way to solve this problem. Okay, I will show you the break apart edit strategy. Ini ada cara yang lain lagi, yaitu dengan cara memisahkan bagian per bagian. Okay, first, we'll find 43 and 22, right? And find the keywords of the problem. Okay, the keyword is altogether. It means that the problem is about addition. Jadi kita sudah menemukan kata kuncinya ada altogether. Maka ini artinya soalnya adalah soal tentang penjumlahan. Okay, first, but the numbers that we find in the problem is 43 and 22. First, please break apart 43 become the tens and ones. Jadi pisahkan 43 ini menjadi puluhan dan satuan. Okay? 4 di sini artinya 40, right? And then 3 di sini artinya ada 3 satuan. Okay, next. 22. 22 means 20 plus 2, right? And next, let's add together. Sekarang kita jumlahkan ke bawah for vertically addition. Kita jumlahkan secara vertikal atau ke bawah. First, start from the ones. Kita mulai dari satuannya. 3 ditambah 2. 5, right? And then 40 plus 20 equals 60. 60, is it correct? Let's see. Yes, 60 and 5. And let's add together and it will become 65. Jadi hasilnya adalah 65. Dari mana? Dari menjumlahkan ke bawah antara 3 dengan 2, hasilnya 5. And then 40 plus 20 equals 60. And the result is 65. Or you try to add together from the numbers here. Or 3 plus 2 equals 5. And then 4 plus 2 equals 6. So the result is 65. And the conclusion is, so the cookies they made altogether are 65. Okay, I hope you got it. And let's go to the next story. There were 39 apples on a tree. There were 23 apples on another tree. How many apples were there on the two trees in total? Okay, ini soal penjumlahan atau pengurangan? Okay, because we find in total here, so it means that the problem is about penjumlahan, masih tentang penjumlahan. And we find 39 and 23. Bilangannya 39 dan 23, dan ini adalah soal penjumlahan. Okay, let's try to solve the problem using the other strategy. And it is about mental math. Jadi Miss akan tunjukkan cara yang lain lagi untuk menyelesaikan soal ini. Okay, first, write down the numbers that you find in the problems. It is 39 and 23, right? And then, let's break the 39 and the 23. Please find out the tens of the numbers. Jadi silakan kalian temukan puluhan dari kedua bilangan ini. Oke, okay. Untuk 39, nilai puluhannya adalah 3, right? Jadi 3 ini kita tuliskan dalam bentuk puluhan menjadi 30. Kemudian 23 untuk puluhannya adalah 20. Jadi kita kelompokkan dulu ya, yang tens mana, kemudian yang ones mana. Oke, please add together 30 plus 20. So the result is 50. And next, please find out the ones. Satuannya adalah 9 dan 3. And please add together them. 9 ditambah 3 sama dengan 12. And we know that 12 equals 10 plus 2. Jadi dari satuannya kita jumlahkan dulu, ada 9 ditambah 3, hasilnya 12. Kemudian ini bisa kita pisahkan menjadi puluhan dan satuan juga, menjadi 10 ditambah 2. And next, let's add the both of the numbers. Jadi sekarang kita jumlahkan nih dari puluhan dan satuannya. Tadi 50, kita pindahkan di sini. And then 10 from this one ya. 10 plus 2. And the result is 62. Okay, so the conclusion is the total of apples were there on the two trees are 62. Okay, let's see the next. Lala had 35 crayons. She lost 15 of them. How many crayons does she have now? Lala mempunyai 35 crayon. Dan dia kehilangan 15 dari 35 crayon tadi. Maka berapakah krayon yang dia punya sekarang? Oke, okay, I want to use a number line. First, find out 35. Oke, okay, I have find it. 35 and I lost 15. Oke, okay, karena kata kuncinya di sini adalah loss. Loss itu hilang. Kalau hilang artinya krayon lama berkurang. It means that this problem is talk about subtraction problem. Oke, okay, ini adalah tentang pengurangan. And when you find the subtraction problem, you can use the number line by counting back. Jadi kalau tadi ketika penjumlahan kalian counting on, menghitung maju, sekarang kalau pengurangan kita menghitung mundur for 15 steps, because 35 minus 15. Oke, okay? Karena dikurangi maka kita mau mundur sebanyak 15 langkah. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and then we get 20. So the result is 20. Okay, next I will show the other ways. Okay, I will use break apart addition strategy. First, please separate 35 become 30 plus 5, right? Dipisahkan dulu puluhan dan satuannya menjadi 30 ditambah 5. And then, next, 15 equals 10 plus 5. Okay, kemudian yang 15 juga dipisahkan menjadi 10 ditambah 5. And then, the result is 20. Yeah, 20 because 5 minus 5 equals 0. And then 30 minus 10 equals 20. So the crayons she has now are 20. Jadi yang dimiliki Lala sekarang tinggal 20. Okay, next. The story is about marbles. If you have 57 marbles and eat 18 of them, how many would you have left? Jika kamu memiliki 57 marbles, marbles itu apa? Kelereng ya. Oh, ini permen berbentuk kelereng. And then eat 18 of them, dan kalian sudah memakan permen itu sebanyak 18. And how many would you have left? Berapakah sisanya? Nah, we find keywords left here. Ada kata-kata left, berarti ini adalah soal pengurangan. Okay, I will use the break apart strategy. First, we separate 57 become 50 plus 7. And then, next for 18. 18 equals 10 plus 8. And now, let's subtract them all. Okay, first, look at this number, 7 minus 8. Can you count it? Oh, it's so difficult to count when you find the small number here. So, let's borrow from the previous number. Okay, karena 7 dikurangi 8 itu nggak sulit ya untuk dihitung. Jadi kita minta bantuan ke bilangan sebelumnya atau bilangan puluhan sebelumnya. Okay, and then it will become 77 plus 40 plus 10 plus 7. Ini kita pisahkan dulu karena 10-nya mau dipinjamkan ke 7. Oke, jadi kita lanjutkan untuk 18. Oke, 18 karena tidak perlu dipinjam-pinjamkan, jadi kita langsung tuliskan kembali 10 ditambah 8. And the result is 39. Oke. How we can count it? 7 minus blank is 7, right? And then 10 minus 8 equals 2. Okay, and then 40 minus 10 equals 30. And then please add together all of the numbers. And the result is 39. So the marbles you have now are 39. Okay, I think that's all for my explanation. And for your assignment is, please cut down your worksheet one by one and then glue on your book. And please solve the problem of them, okay? And thank you for your attention. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.